Next case under section 13, where supplier or recipient is outside India. Services supplied directly in relation to immovable property, including services supplied in this regard by experts, estate agents, supply of accommodation by a hotel, guest house, club or campsite by whatever name called, grant of right to use immovable property like rent or tenancy rights, services for carrying out or coordination of construction of work, including that of architects and interior decorators. So this clause is quite similar to what we discussed under section 12 also. These are all services relating to immovable property like land, building. So for land or any building, if there is any expert, real estate agent, interior decorator, architect, etc., or accommodation in hotel, guest house, club, campsite, etc., these are all related directly to the immovable property. So what was that logic? Same is applicable. What was that? The place where immovable property is located or intended to be located. Intended to be located, also we have discussed, is similar. Say a new property to be constructed. The property is not there. The new bungalow or a new building is to be constructed, and for that architect or interior decorator has been appointed. So it is intended to be located at that place. So the same place will become the place of supply of services. Like, take an example, a real estate agent service to a company is given in Mumbai by a Delhi agent for Dubai office. So Mumbai company want to have purchase one office in Dubai. For that purpose, a agent from Delhi is appointed. So what is place of supply of services of this service, agent service? It is relating to the real estate immovable property. So wherever that immovable property is located, that is the place of supply of service, that is Dubai, because the office is situated in Dubai. Again, exactly the same principle, again and again now this is coming. If supplied at more than one location, including a location in taxable territory, then place of supply will be location in taxable territory. If supplied in more than one state or union territory, then place of supply will be proportion to the value of services separately collected or determined as per the contract, if no such contract as may be prescribed. Exactly same example, services provided, this is relating to two properties, we can say one is in Japan and one is in Mumbai, right? For both of these properties, a real estate agent has been appointed or an architect has been appointed, he is giving consultancy for both of this, and then one of this located in Mumbai, so the location of supply will be in Mumbai. And if both of them are in Mumbai, or both of them are in India, then services provided at Delhi and Mumbai, then place of supply will be Mumbai and Delhi in the proportion as per the contract. And if there is no contract, then as per whatever is the prescribed method by notification. In next case, actually we are covering three cases simultaneously. First one, services supplied by a banking company or a financial institution or a non-banking financial company, NBFC normally called as, to account holders. Second is intermediary services. Intermediary services like agent, sales agent you have appointed for exploring new market in Europe or Africa or other country. So he is providing you intermediary services. And services consisting of hiring of means of transport. So like any vehicle, means of transport, including yachts but excluding aircraft and vessels. So this is not applicable for aircraft and vessels up to a period of 1 month. So if you are hiring yachts, then what will be the place of supply of services? The location of supplier of service, it is more important. So there is A Limited of Mumbai, which is availing banking services or any kind of financial services from a bank which is located in USA. So location of supplier, location of bank is USA, place of supply will be USA. So this is based on location of supplier. The next one, transportation of goods other than by way of mail or courier. So for mailing or couriering services, this clause is not applicable, but you are transporting goods, then place of destination of such goods, where these goods are ultimately delivered, that destination is the place of supply of services. So take an example, A Limited of US is sending goods to Surat in a truck, and for that purpose A Limited is having presence in US. They might have appointed somebody at Mumbai port, and that person, he said, okay, from Mumbai port keep this upload these goods in a truck and send it to Surat. So that transportation of goods which is taking place will be covered under this clause. What is the place of destination of these goods? The final destination is Surat. So for A Limited of US, the place of supply of services will be Surat, where transportation of goods is involved. Next one, passenger transportation services. This is very similar as per section 12. The place where passengers embarks on the conveyance for a continuous journey. So where the person starts the journey, where he board in that particular bus, where he starts that particular continuous journey, that place will be the place of supply of service. Say a bus services is hired from Mumbai to Goa. A company want to take its employees to Goa for some kind of a training purpose, say for example. So for that purpose they have hired one bus from Mumbai to Goa. So what will be the place of supply? Where the passenger embarks on conveyance. So where these employees are actually getting into the vehicle at Mumbai, that is the place of supply. Place of supply will be Mumbai. Similar as what we discussed under section 12. Next provision, services provided on board a conveyance during the course of a passenger transport operation, including services intended to be wholly or substantially consumed while on board. So there might be some services like catering services on a train or in a flight that are provided, and these services are consumed substantially or wholly between the travel itself. So if a train is traveling from say Mumbai to Calcutta, then it is running through different states. So what will be the place of supply of these services? This provision is very similar to what we discussed in section 12. The first schedule point of departure of that conveyance for the journey, like in our example Mumbai to Calcutta, the first schedule point for departure is Mumbai, so place of supply will be Mumbai. An example, catering services in a flight from Mumbai to Dubai. So the first schedule point of departure is Mumbai, that will become place of supply of services for catering services that are to be provided on board for that particular flight. Now the residual cases. If you want to determine place of supply of services and any of the above clauses are not applicable, then you fall in residual cases. So what is the place of supply in such residual cases? Location of the recipient is available, then location of recipient of services. So if supplier knows what is the location of recipient of services, as per his record he knows the address of recipient is so and so, that will become place of supply of services. Location of recipient is not available, location of the supplier of services will become place of supply of service. Say for example, services to A Limited, which is registered at Mumbai, some services from outside country are being given to A Limited, which is registered in Mumbai. So the location of recipient is available to that person, place of supply will become Mumbai. But consider a case where services are provided by one USA-based company to Mr. A in Goa, whose address is not available. Might be a company in USA have conducted some kind of an activity in Goa, or say in any place rather, and a person from Goa has participated in that activity, so he has availed the services from this company, but this company don't have any concrete address proof of Mr. A. They don't know what is the location of Mr. A. He is located in Goa, but company don't know. So location of recipient is not available. In that case, location of supplier of service will be considered. So location of supplier of service is USA, place of supply of service will be USA. Finally, there is one category called online information and database access or retrieval services. We are going to discuss about this special category of services in a different chapter altogether. So just for the time being, go through with this provision. Again, we will address the issue. So in simple words, online information or database access retrieval services means like a YouTube. We are watching a video on YouTube. That is online information or database access. We are accessing or retrieving the specific video, and that server might be in India or outside India, that company might be in India, outside India, we don't know. So in such cases, what will be the place of supply? Location of recipient of services. So if a service of YouTube is being availed by a person sitting in Mumbai, location of services of supply is Mumbai, place of supply of service will be Mumbai. But see, in this online or digital world, how you can come to know about the location of recipient of services? So the law states there are various different categories to identify this. Recipient will be considered as situated in a taxable territory if any one of the following conditions are fulfilled. Taxable territory means India. Recipient will be considered as situated in India if any two of following conditions are fulfilled. So it is not actual physical presence when you are accessing that particular YouTube video, but out of following, if two are satisfied, then it is deemed that you are situated in India. What are these? Number one, address of recipient in taxable territory. So say Mr. A is from Mumbai, and as per the records of supplier of services, the address of Mr. A is of Mumbai, right? So that is in taxable territory. That is one of the criteria. There are seven criteria, we will see one by one. The card of recipient that is used to pay the services is issued in taxable territory. Say you want to purchase some online books, right? Online videos, etc. You want to download something, and these are paid services. So you use a debit card or credit card. So the card of recipient that is used to pay the services is issued in taxable territory. So if that card is issued by an Indian bank in India, then also the second category is considered to be, recipient will be considered in situated in taxable territory. Billing address in taxable territory. Probably your actual address is not available with supplier, but when you download it or when you order something on any website, he asks you what will be your delivery address, what will be your billing address, and in that you mention the address of India, address of Mumbai, say for example. So billing address is in taxable territory. Internet protocol address. We normally identify this as IP address. For every computer, every device, we have this IP address. If that IP address is in taxable territory, if that is in India. Bank of recipient in taxable territory. In second, point number two, we discuss the card payment. But in point number 5, if you are not making a card payment, that is debit card or credit card, but if you are making a payment by online means, net banking, then bank of recipient is in India. So point 5 is in that regard. Country code of SIM card is of taxable territory. Now, you might be watching a YouTube video on your mobile, and the country code of your SIM card is obviously of the country in which you are using the SIM card. Say it is India, you are using it in Mumbai. So country code of your SIM card will be Mumbai. It will be in taxable territory. And 7, fixed line used by recipient is in taxable territory. Might be you are not watching the YouTube video on your mobile, but it is through a landline or it is through a wired cable or broadband connection, then that is, if that fixed line use is in taxable territory, it is in India, then the condition is fulfilled. So what you have to remember over here is, not all the conditions, any two of the following conditions are fulfilled, then that person will be treated as he is situated in taxable territory. So take an example, if you are actually having a bank account in Indian bank account, in Indian bank, right? And you are actually out of country, you have visited in say Singapore, you are in Singapore, and you are using this kind of online information database services, okay? So logically what you will feel is, you are using these services in Singapore, place of supply of services will be Singapore, but check this on the 7 criterias and then you will get the correct answer. Say address of recipient. So whatever is your address, as per the records of supplier, whether that is in India, that will be checked. Card use, you are not making any card payment, you are using some kind of online services, for that you are not making card payment, so this clause is not applicable. Billing address, yes. Now that person, that site, that supplier will ask you the billing address. So if in that billing address, the address is of Indian territory, say Mumbai, then clause, one of the clauses fulfilled. Let us take that while you purchase something, while you download some material, any video, any textbook, you are making some payment, and in that, in the billing address, you mention your billing address of Mumbai. So one of these 7 clauses are fulfilled. Then internet protocol address is taxable territory. Probably you might be using internet facility in Singapore, local based. So obviously IP protocol will not be of India. Bank of recipient is in taxable territory. Now you are making online payment through your bank in India, net banking of a bank in India. So second point is also fulfilled. Country code of SIM card is taxable territory. You are not using your mobile phone, so this is not applicable. Fixed line is used is in taxable territory. You are using the fixed line of Singapore, so that is not applicable. Now, out of the 7 clauses, see, these 2 clauses are fulfilled. You are actually in Singapore, you are downloading some video or some material from any site and making the payment. But for the purpose of this act, what will be the place of supply of service? The place of supply of service will be India. The location of recipient of the service, that is India, it will be considered as situated in India if any two conditions are fulfilled. Now you are fulfilling condition number 3 and condition number 5. So it is deemed that you are receiving the services in taxable territory of India. The location of recipient of service or the place of supply of service will be India.